By time when I joined this place, I found a school when the population was also still low. It was around 1,200. I talked to the administrators and the fellow colleagues. We tried to mobilize them because the place is nearing a trading center. Most of the children could engage themselves in income generating activities. So we went ahead to sensitize the parents to bring their children back at school. Among them were the crippled, those who could not move. We also found that those who are the deaf, we found some of those, the albinos, were just lying there outside. So we went out to talk to their parents to convince them, because now this school is under-inclusive. It can accommodate all sorts of learners, regardless of their disability.
Twafuna okumanyisibwa ni headmaster waife oyo nti abaana bonna bantu ng'oti niifwe, mubaleete wano basome. Owange namuleeta oluuyi luno lufu tayogera aye mpera ano.
The parents are coming on board because they have, through sensitized, they have realized that children, this one can also do something. Instead of leaving them outside, they have now come to know that disability does not mean inability. So they can now support, at least they can buy these books. At first they had that negative attitude. Issue to do with the uniform, they could not buy. I talked to my boy, said, no, we shall, let us improvise. So with the uniform, they are covered.
Yomwana kati tewali kyatasobola kukola. Ani wabatawulira kiki, naye kati asatambula amanyi nti wemba nsala kubo. Ntunula eno, ntunula eno bwenti.
The challenges at times I have is the commitment of other teachers towards these children, especially during classroom instruction. You battle with them, so please do the needful to make sure that this child learns. And at times also feeding, because children can't stay on empty stomach from morning up to evening. Once a child lacks that, learning becomes a problem.
Download the app on App Store or Google Play Store now. Vision Digital Experience, the future of media.